H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, so we will start with the class. And the topic that we are going to start with, it is the Quality Center. Now, before we get into the quality center, can you tell me what are the different steps that we had followed in the manual testing? Yes, the different steps of the manual testing. We started with the test requirement gathering. Test plan. And analysis. Test design. Test implementation. And execution. Defect reporting. And tracking. Finally, we had the test closure activities. Okay. So these are the different steps that we perform in order to do the testing process. Now, there are certain kind of issues that we got to address over here. So we will try to understand about that. So now if we take a project team over here with a QA team, so we have a QA team here with the team of testers. So there are many testers in the team who are present here. Now can you tell me, are we going to assign all the roles and responsibilities to the single tester in the team? Or will all of them perform the same activities? No, they are not going to perform the same activities, right? Okay. So what exactly happens here? The different testers are performing the different activities in the team over here. And we are assigning the different roles and responsibilities to the different testers in the team. For example, some of them will be preparing the test documents, right? Some testers will be doing the testing process. So here the documents should be shared within the team. But how do we share the documents? So sharing of the documents, this is one issue that we need to address. Correct? Then the communication and coordination within the team, how do you communicate? Are you going to send an email or are you going to give a call? So how do you communicate within the team? So this is one more issue that we need to address. And not just that, you will have to interact with the business analyst. You will have to interact with the developers in the team. And then the team lead, the project manager, should keep the updates about the testing process. So they should be able to track the status. and they should be able to generate the reports so that they can identify what is the performance of your testing team. All the documents that are prepared, they should be maintained properly, the security. And whatever changes you make, the changes have to be recorded, the history of the project, right? So these are some of the activities that are to be managed, or let's say these are some of the issues that we got to consider. So in order to manage these activities, we need a tool that is called as test management tool. And we have several examples of the test management tools over here, like we have the Quality Center from HP. We have the IBM Rational Quality Manager. We have the Bugzilla tool. We have the Jira tool. Correct? And some of the companies have their own inbuilt tools as well. Okay? So these are some of the tools over here, the test management tools, correct? And these test management tools are nothing but, they belong to the category of the testing tools. We have lot of different types of testing tools that are available. The categories of the testing tools, like performance testing tools, automation testing tool, right? So this is also one category of testing tool, that is test management tool. And all these tools that I've given the examples over here, these belong to the test management tool category. Now when there are so many different types of tools, can you tell me which tool are you going to use? Which one do you select then? There are so many of them, right? Which one are you going to learn? You need not learn all of them. Okay, because all of them are going to work in the same way, because they belong to the same category, the test management tools, right, which are used to manage the testing activities of the project. All of them behave in the same way. The defect reporting is going to be the same. The status, like, you know, the new defect, closed defect, right? So all of them are going to be the same, because these tools are developed based on the testing activities that are present over here. And these are the standard testing activities. They do not change. The same steps are followed in all the different types of testing or in the different projects, correct? So we are not performing these activities based on these tools, but these test management tools have to be developed as per our testing activities. So no matter which tool you consider, they are going to behave in the same way when they belong to a particular category of a tool. So there is no need for you to learn all of them. You learn one tool over here and then the remaining ones are going to behave in the same way. You can simply explore them and start using. Correct? And especially these inbuilt tools for a particular company. Now you cannot go to each and every company trying to find out what kind of tool they are using and try to learn it. It is practically not possible. And neither they are going to share their inbuilt tools with you, right? So you learn one tool. We will learn the Quality Center from HP, because it has maximum number of features when you compare it with the other tools. And moreover, it is used in most of the IT projects. And that is why we will be considering the Quality Center tool, okay, from the HP company. Then we will see the architecture of the Quality Center tool. So we have a Quality Center server here on which the different documents can be created. We can create your requirements, that is RTM here. We can list down the requirements. We can create the test cases, the defect reports. Even the execution can be done here. Execution means it's a manual execution. Okay, we are not talking about the automatic execution because it is not an automation testing tool. So this point, please remember, Quality Center is not an automation testing tool. Alright. And on this Quality Center server, all the testers can create these documents by connecting the Quality Center server using their Quality Center client. So if you want to access the server, there should be a Quality Center client installed on your computer, then you can access it. So all the QAs in the team lead, the project manager, the developers will be having the access to this Quality Center server. And apart from this, even the BA can get the access to the Quality Center server. So whoever is going to access this Quality Center, everybody should have the Quality Center client on their computer, and then only they can access the Quality Center server. And each of the users will be given a different user ID and password. Okay, so they should log in with their user ID and password into this Quality Center server. Whatever the changes they make, they get recorded. Whatever the documents are getting created, they get created on their name. The developer can update the defect over here. So this is the architecture of your Quality Center. A Quality Center server with a Quality Center client. And this is, you can see that it is a client server model. A web-based application. Okay. Quality Center client, Vaishali, it is nothing but it is a tool, okay, using which you can access the Quality Center server. I will show you. I'll demonstrate and show you what is a Quality Center server. Okay, Suchita. Is it clear, everybody? What is this Quality Center exactly and then why it is used? Yes, Parish. We call it as a Mercury Quality Center because it's developed by Mercury and then the license is currently with the HP. So on your computers, Srinivas, you have both the Quality Center server and the client. Both of them are installed on your computers. Clear, everybody? So now I'll show you how to use this tool, but before we start with the usage of the tool, I'll tell you some methodology over here that you need to follow while we are discussing the tools. So while we are discussing the tools, first of all, I'll be giving you the demonstration. And after that, I will be giving you some time to practice or try out the tool. And then definitely you will be getting some issues with this tool. Okay. And we will try to troubleshoot your issues that you have with the tool. Okay. Some of you may get and some of you may not get. So I request all the other participants to just wait and watch how the issues are resolved. Only the usage related issues will be solved in the class, and if it is the issue that is related to your installation, so I will be telling you and you can contact the H2K technical team who have installed the software for you. Alright. And even in the real-time projects, you should be able to distinguish between what are the issues that are related to the usage and what are the issues that are related to the installation. Okay. Because in case it is the usage related issue, you should be able to resolve it on your own. Not that every small issue you go and, you know, bug your team lead or, you know, other testers in the team. No, that is not at all a good practice. Okay. So to some extent, you will be able to solve those issues. And in case you have the installation issues, you should be able to identify that, yes, this is an installation issue. And you can immediately report it to the technical support team of your company and get the things resolved for yourself. Is that clear, everyone? So just learning the tool is not important, but you should be able to explore it. You should be able to resolve the issues on your own to some extent. Fine. Now one more thing, We will be creating again some of the documents over here which we have already done on the manual testing. And here we are not going to focus on how to create the documents, but we will focus on how to use a tool. So now again you are not going to ask me what is a precondition, what are the steps that we need to write, what is the meaning of a test data. No, we are not discussing all that because we have already done that documentation part in the manual testing. So here we will see how to do the same thing instead of Excel sheet, how to use a quality center. Alright. So you can use the same projects that we have already done. Karishma, you can ask your question please. And then Shruti, what is a test director? Test director is nothing but it is the older version of the quality center. We were calling it as a test director, but now we call it as the quality center. The latest version we are calling it as ALM. So it is just a change of name that we have. Divya, not the quality center link. Okay, so I think you have sent the session link that you are supposed to join. Okay, no problem. By Monday, get it installed. Okay. Okay, isn't one tester who is working on one module has to do all the phases of the testing for that module? No, Karishma. If you are assigned some features for creating the test documents, then testing of those features could be assigned to the different tester in the team. Alright? So you will not be assigned all the activities for the same module. No, that will not be done. Okay? And the load runner is a performance testing tool. It is not a test management tool. Yes, Radha, quality center is now called as ALM, application lifecycle management. Okay, if anybody has not got your quality centers installed, hold on, let me check. So I am pasting here the email ID of our technical support team. So you can send an email to them. You can get the quality center installed on your computers. To a quality center tool, the license is with the HP, developed by Mercury. Alright. Load runner, Karishma, it is a performance testing tool, not the test management tool. You forgot what is an agile scrum? It is a SDLC model, software development lifecycle model that we discussed in the beginning. Okay, I will just demonstrate and in the weekend you can do the practice, okay? I will show you how to open it and all. Okay, Karishma, what is the difference between the different kind of tools? We will see it later. Okay. See, you have not learnt any tools. It is too early for you to, figure out the differences between them. First, learn the tools and then you will be able to identify the differences on your own. Okay. So, let me check whether my quality center is ready. Give me 1 minute. Everyone, I'll check if my quality center is ready. Okay, so my quality center is ready. After the quality center is installed on your computer, you will be able to see two icons on your computer. One is Mercury Quality Center, another is Quality Center Explorer. Okay. So we are not going to open this Mercury Quality Center, but it simply means that the Quality Center is installed on your computer. We will be working with QC Explorer. Okay, all of you, even though the software is installed, please don't open. So first of all, I'll be giving you the demonstration and then I'll give you some time to practice. So till then, simply observe what we are doing over here. Okay, otherwise you're going to miss the steps. And then, you know, we have to keep on repeating the steps and then they get really messed up. So make sure don't open your Quality Center tool till we are done with this. So I have the QC Explorer here on my computer. So you need to double click on this QC Explorer. Do you see? This kind of window opens. And here in the drop down, you will get the address. You need to select it. So do you remember that I said that it is a web-based application? So can you see here HTTP? Then you have the name of the computer. You have the 8080 over here. It is a port using which your computer is connecting to the Quality Center server. And then we have to log in into this Quality Center bin. Then I click on the go button here in order to log in. So there is an authenticate button here, but before that we need to enter the user ID and password. In the real-time project, each one of you will be given a different user ID and password. But here the demo is installed on your computer, so you can enter the username as alex_qc, password is blank. Don't enter anything in the password. Username is alex_qc. Then you click on the authenticate button that is present here. It will show you which is a domain, which is a project to which you are assigned. Even in the real projects, okay? So when you click on the authenticate button, automatically it will start showing to which project you are assigned. And then you click on the login button here. It will take you to the Quality Center. Domain means, Shruti, it is a field that you are assigned to. For example, let's say if you are working for a finance project, healthcare based project, retailing project, e-commerce project, right? So it is a domain or a field or an industry, we can say. Clear? And in the Quality Center, we have the four modules over here. Requirements module is there, test plan module is there, test lab module is there, and then the defects module is there. So there are four modules here in the Quality Center that we will have to learn. So the first one is requirements module, second one is the test plan module, third one is the test lab module, the last one is the defects module. So here in the test design, what we do, we prepare the requirement traceability matrix. We prepare okay, sorry. I think you know I had got muted. Let me repeat it for you. So we have the four modules over here. The four modules of the quality center are requirements module, test plan module, and then we have the defects module. So in the test design phase, we were preparing the RTM. The same thing we will do here in the requirements. In the test plan, don't misunderstand it, for the test plan document, we are not preparing the test plan document here. We will be preparing the test cases in the test plan module of the quality center. Then in the test lab, we do the test implementation and execution. In the defects module, we do the defect reporting and tracking. So these are the different activities of your testing process that we are mapping here in the quality center. Is that clear, everybody? For the test data, Joelna, we are going to take again the Word document itself. We are not going to write the test data document over here in the quality center. It has not provided any feature for us to create the test data document. Suchita, the quality center is a test management tool. Right from the creation of the requirements onwards, we can start using the quality center tool. So here, do you see? We have the requirements, we have the test plan, we have the test lab, and then the defects. Right? So we will start working on any of the project which we have already done in the manual testing. We can consider any project that you want. Shruti, we can attach the documents over here. We are going to create it in the Word document itself. Okay, your boundary value analysis and then your equivalence class partition. You can create it in the Word document or the Excel document, but we do not have any option over here.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.